I mean, one thing about spending the rest of my life with her, what I think about is the fact that I have so much fun with her. I don't see there's ever gonna be a time when we're not on the same page. Every ridiculous, stupid plan idea I have or pull out, she's just so game for. And so I kind of feel like she just puts up with me, and I guess that's half the battle right there.
I thought we were just going for a wine and cheese pairing. So we did that, and we were taking a walk in the grounds, and David starts to say, "So, do you recognize any of the people here at the vineyard today?" And we're walking down the hill, he grabs my hands, he starts talking about how much he loves me and I'm a wonderful person, and he says, "All these people here are a testament to how wonderful of a friend you are." And I look over and there's two picnic tables filled with all of my best friends who came in from all across the country, who were all there for this moment. And he dropped on one knee and I started crying, and I said, "Yes, of course." It was a complete surprise. David and my lovely maid of honor, Melissa, planned this whole thing out. He was gonna propose. He told me that it was going to happen in December, which was a lie, but that's okay.
I love that Mandy is always happy. She has such a good attitude about things. She is so easygoing, which is funny because we make spreadsheets of everything we do. I mean, we organize everything. If I am like, "Hey, let's just go do this," or "Let's just not do that plan that we were originally gonna have and change it up at the last minute," she just rolls with it. There was a ski trip that some of our friends were kind of going on. We both decided to go up and we ended up riding in the same car together. This was in West Virginia, so it was like a 5-hour drive each way. And I guess it's one of those kind of deals where we were either gonna kill each other or probably fall in love. You know, that's a long time to be with someone in a close space. So we kind of, we hit it off and talked, and it was like, "Hey, let's maybe try going on a date." I realized she was the one 2 or 3 months in. In fact, I think we were kind of on the same page, and the only way we'd ever tell each other was after we'd been drinking quite a bit, and then we get kind of that like drunken confessional mode. We'd be like, "Oh man, let's get married." Like, "Yeah, yeah." But then we'd sober up a little bit, like, "No, we didn't say that to each other."
David, you may kiss your bride.
When I think about 5 years, 10 years, 15, 50 years, I just see that we're going to always be having fun, always be doing good stuff together. I'm so impressed by the kind of person she is all the time. I have so much respect for her. I think it's just going to be wonderful to spend more time with her, get to know her better throughout the rest of our lives.